for your vocal warm-up, Kim Newcomb.
Good morning. How's everyone feeling? Woo, it's Tuesday. All right, so Jean did a great job of talking about alignment. You're gonna keep that. Make sure your feet are under your hips are under your shoulders, and your ears are right around where they should be. Peter mentioned that yesterday. Can everyone just go, woo?
Woo!
You are ready. Yes, thank you for the physical participation. I know you talked about alignment and breathing already. This is your daily reminder. Go ahead and take your hand, put your thumb on your belly button, and let your hand drop. Take a nice deep breath. And out. Good. Take your other hand, put it on your neck. I know, morning, right? Go ahead and swallow. Do you feel something move up and down? Cool. That's your larynx. That's where your vocal cords are housed. Now, take a deep breath and feel what happens here. Ready, breathe in. And out. Another deep breath. And out. Good, relax. So what you should feel is that your larynx goes down. It's nice and relaxed. Your diaphragm goes down, makes room for your lungs to expand. That's connected to your trachea. Top of your trachea is the larynx. The larynx goes down, and a lowered larynx is a good sign for singing. If you don't remember any of that, all you need to know is that when you take a nice low breath, it really sets you up for success. So, can everyone go? Very nice. Make sure you're really sliding through all of those. You don't have to be, but take your hand like a paintbrush. Ready, here you go. And up. And up. Good. Everyone say e-ah-e-ah.
E-ah-e-ah.
Good. Now you're going to do that again and pay attention to the position of your tongue. Ready?
E-I-E-R.
So on an E vowel, the blades of your tongue should be touching your top back molars and the tip of your tongue is down. And when you say ah, it relaxes, right? Ah is a more backward sounding vowel. E is a more forward sounding vowel. Can you bubble with that E feeling? So if you were to go, do you hear a difference? Great, so try it. I believe in you. It's a little challenging. Ready? So from now on, you're gonna bubble with your tongue in an E position. Ready, go. And up. Yes, and you don't have to change the key. I'll do that for you. Instead, take the opportunity to take a deep, oh, get it out, get it out. Instead, take the opportunity to take a nice deep breath. Ready? Yes. Now you can go up. Good job. And up. We're gonna keep going from there. Make sure you bend your knees on the high notes. Transfer that forward E feeling into just opening your mouth and singing through an E. So try. Ready, go. If that feels, ready, go. If that feels a little weird, it's probably because you're manipulating things you don't need to. If your tongue's already in the position of an E, you should just be able to open your mouth. Can you all take your hands and go? Ready, go. Yes, and this is very much in tempo. Ready, go. And down. And down. And down. Nice. Everyone say, sing.
Sing.
Say, sin.
Sing.
So in the word sing, on the NG, the back of your tongue goes up. For sin, the tip of your tongue is at the very front. I want sing, you're gonna go and up. Nice low breath, and up. Yeah, good job. And up. Good, try. So in your upper register, try. Ready, go. Good, down the octave. Ready, go. Both of those should feel pretty similar in ease. If it's not, try and relax a little bit more. Everyone go, breathe in and out. Very nice. Ready, go. Down the octave. Back out the octave. And back down. Good job. That takes a lot of vocal agility. You should be very proud of yourselves. Everyone say, tho, ah. Go. Very good. Very pure vowels, and it's T-H-O. The exercise sounds like this. We went from bubbling, which is free and easy because your larynx is floating in a bunch of muscles, so you gotta really relax your face when you're bubbling, to transferring that to an E vowel, which is really great for vocal fold closure. If you don't know, if you're having any breathy tone going on, try singing on an E vowel. It's very, very helpful. And we're gonna transfer that and the forward placement of the ng to multiple vowels. So the exercise goes like this. It's tho, e, ah. I'm gonna break it down, echo me. Tho, e, ready, go. Tho, e. Nice. Oh, remember what we did when we went. Make sure you're descending joyfully. Tho, e, ready, go. Tho. Nice. Now try. E, ready, here you go. E. I went ready, here you go. Just sing. E. Now try. Oh, ready, here you go. Oh. Yes, so together it's tho, e, ah, tho, e, ah. Listen again. Tho, e, ah. Ready, go. Tho, e, ah. Yes, now take your hands like an infinity sign. We're going to go tho, e, now, can you make that the most beautiful thing you've sung today? So really easy and already. Here you go. So and up. So and up. So very nice. Can you sing in this key? If you want to sing lead, your part is gonna be D D D D D D D D D D. Leads, try that. D D D D D. Good. Whatever octave is comfortable for you is totally fine. If you're gonna sing tenor, it's gonna be Dee 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 dee. Ready, tenors go. Dee 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 dee. Yes, yes, just those five notes. Baritones, your dee 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 dee. Ready, go. Dee 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 dee. And basses would be. I'm not a bass. Dee 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 dee. Ready, here you go, basses go. Dee dee dee. Very nice. Any of those four parts that you want to sing, we're gonna do together now. So it's leads, tenors, baritones, basses. Yes, ready, and dee. Can you bubble on that? Ready, and sing it on D, ready, go. Sing it on da, ready, go. Da, da, sing it on do, ready, go. Back to da and sing. Da, da. Sing it like a song on da. Da, 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 da. Thank you for your time. Have a great day.
I'll introduce you that way.